Today's class, we are going to discuss linear convolution. We'll be discussing how to find the linear convolution of two sequences using graphical method. So let's see. So I'm going to take two sequences. X of n is my first sequence and I'm going to take it with length l. H of n is my second sequence and I'm going to consider it is having a length m. And the linear convolution of these two will give a result y of n. Then y of n will be having a length equal to l plus m minus 1. So this is a case when you're taking two sequences. One is having length l, second one is having length m. Then the resultant sequence will be having a length equal to l plus m minus 1. Now let's see what is the equation to find the linear convolution. So the equation to find the linear convolution is y of n equal to sigma k equal to minus infinity to infinity x of k into h of n minus k. So this is the equation to find your y of n. Here I'm going to take this l plus m minus 1 as n. Then your small letter n will vary from 0 to n minus 1. So this is the case. So this is the equation to find linear convolution. That is y of n is the linear convolution result, and y of n equal to sigma k equal to minus infinity to infinity x of k into h of n minus k, where x of k is your first input sequence, h of k is your second input sequence, and here the small letter n will vary from 0 to capital N minus 1. So this is the case. Now let's do an example of how to perform linear convolution. I'm going to take two sequences. My first sequence is x of n equal to set 1, 2, 3, 1. H of n is set 1, 1, 1. So here the time positions are 0, 1, 2 and 3, 4, x of n. That is the length of x of n is 4. And h of n, the positions are 0, 1 and 2. And the length of h of n is 3. Now let's find what is the length of your resultant sequence. So length of resultant sequence is L plus M minus 1. Here your L is 4 and your M is 3. Sorry, here it is 4 and 3 minus 1. That is 7 minus 1 is 6. So your resultant sequence, that is y of n, will be having a length equal to 6. That is y of n. The n will vary from 0 to 5. So your small letter n will vary from 0 to 5. So this is the case. Now let's write the general equation to find y of n. Y of n equal to sigma k equal to minus infinity to infinity x of k h of n minus k. So your n will vary from 0 to 5. So first let's find what is y of 0. Here your small letter n is 0. So y of 0 equal to sigma k equal to minus infinity to infinity x of k into h of n is 0 here. So 0 minus k, that is minus k. Now I told we are going to do this using graphical method. And how to find the linear convolution using circular convolution, we have already uploaded a video. So if you want to know how to find linear convolution using circular convolution, please check that video. I'll share the link in my description box. Okay, so let's do this. First, let's draw your x of k. You have x of n, so you can draw x of k. But if you have to plot this sequence, so the time positions are 0, 1, 2 and 3. 0, 1, 2 and 3. The values are in 0, the value is 1. in one the value is 2, and in 2 the value is 3, and in 3 the value is again 1. So this is your x of k signal. Now let's plot h of k. You need h of minus k. You need h of minus k, but first let's plot h of k. The time positions are 0, 1 and 2. 0, 1 and 2. The values are 1, again 1 and 1. So this is your h of k. Now, how to find h of minus k from h of k? H of minus k is nothing but the mirror image of h of k. So you have h of k. To apply a negative to the time points, that is, if you apply a negative to 0, it is again 0. If you apply a negative to 1, it is minus 1. A negative to 2 will make it minus 2. So you are going to shift your signal to the negative quadrant. So this is your h of k. I'm going to draw h of minus k here, that is in 0, minus 1 and minus 2. The value is same, 1, 1 and 1 again. So this is your h of minus k. See, this is h of k and this is h of minus k. That is, h of minus k is the mirror image of your h of k. Now you have to take the product of the common terms in x of k and h of minus k, because your equation is sigma k equal to minus infinity to infinity x of k into h of minus k. Okay, so I'm going to remove this h of k now. So you have your x of k and h of minus k. I'm going to take the product of the common terms. Here there is 0 and here there is also 0. So there is no other common point. So take the product of the values at 0. For x of k, the value at the position 0 is 1. Also for h of minus k, at 0 the value is 1. So 1 into 1. So remaining, there is, since there is no common points, the points will be, the product will be 0. So plus 0 plus 0 plus etc. So the value is 1 into 1, that is 1. So you got your y of 0 as 1. Now let's find y of 1. Y of 1 is, y of 1 equal to sigma k equal to minus infinity to infinity x of k into h of n minus k. Here n is 1, so 1 minus k. So I'm going to write this 1 minus k as minus k plus 1. So I'll write it here, that is k equal to minus infinity to infinity x of k h of minus k plus 1. So why I have written it like this? Since we have our h of minus k, h of minus k plus 1 is nothing but adding a 1 to the time points. So if you add 1 to this time point 0, what is 0 plus 1? 0 plus 1 is 1. Again, minus 1 plus 1 is 0. Also, minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1. So your new time points will be 0, 1 and minus 1. I'm going to draw the signal here. My new signal, that is h of minus k plus 1, I'm going to draw. The time points are, I'm going to add a 1 to the 0, that is 1, and minus 1 plus 1 is 0, minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1. So these are the new time points and the values are 1, 1 and 1. So this is your new signal, that is h of minus k plus 1. Now, according to the equation, take the product of the common terms present in x of k and h of minus k plus 1 and add. Okay, I'll remove this h of minus k. since it is not needed now. Okay, so what are the common points? 0 and 1 are the common points. So what is the value of x of k at 0? It is 1. And for h of minus k plus 1, the value is 1. So 1 into 1 plus at the time position 1, what is the value of x of k? It is 2. And for h of minus k plus 1, the value at the position 1 is again 1. So 2 into 1. So 1 into 1 is 1 plus 2 into 1 is 2. So the result is 3. So you got your y of 1 is 3. Now you have to find y of 2. Y of 2 equal to sigma k equal to minus infinity to infinity x of k h of minus k plus 2, or simply 2 minus k, or in the next step I write sigma k equal to minus infinity to infinity x of k h of minus k plus 2. So now you have to form h of minus k plus 2. Your x of k is the same. Okay, so you have your h of minus k plus 1. So this minus k plus 2 can be written as minus k plus 1 plus 1. So that is nothing but adding a 1 to this minus k plus 1. So how can you form your h of minus k plus 2 from h of minus k plus 1? So you have to add a 1 to this signal. That is, you are adding a 1 to the time positions to the signal. Okay. So I'll make it more clear by writing in the next step. That is x of k into h of minus k plus 1 plus 1. So you already have your this one. Minus k plus 1 you already have. Here it is. So add a 1 to the time positions. Okay. So simply shift the time position up to one point to the positive quadrant, that is to the right side. So now I'm going to form the signal, that is h of minus k plus 2. That is by adding a 1 to these time positions. So if you add a 1 to this one, what it will be? It will be 2. So 2. So add a 1 to 0, it will be 1. Add a 1 to minus 1, it will be 0. The values are 1, 1 and 1. So this is your signal, that is h of minus k plus 2. Here again, you have to take the product of the common points of h of minus k plus 2 and x of k. The common points are 0, 1 and 2. Here also 0, 1 and 2 is present. So common points are 0, 1 and 2. I am saying common points because in x of k you can see there is a 3. But there is no 3, time position 3 in h of minus k plus 2. So if you take the product, it will be 0. So that is why you are going to take only common points. So the values are at 0, 1 and 2. And here also there is 0, 1 and 2. So what is the value? At 0, x of k value is 1. And for h of minus k plus 2, at 0 the value is again 1. So 1 into 1 plus at position 1, x of k is 2. Here it is 1. So 2 into 1 plus at position 2, the value is 3. Here it is 1. So 3 into 1. So the result is 1 plus 2 plus 3. That is 5 plus 1, that is 6. So you got your, you are finding y of 2. So y of 2 is 6. So you got your y of 2 as 6. So this is the case how to find the linear convolution. That is, first you are going to draw your first sequence, that is x of k. Now draw the h of k and take h of minus k. Then take h of minus k plus 1, then h of minus k plus 2, h of minus k plus 3. Up to the n value, how much you have to find. For this case, you have to change your n from 0 to 5 since your length is 6. So it varies from, n varies from 0 to 5. So you have to vary your h of k signal and then take the product of the common terms and add. And hence you can find your y of n values, that is y of 0, y of 1, y of 2 up to y of 5. So if you are doing it for the first time, it would be a little difficult for you. But if you are going on doing the y of 0, y of 1, y of 2, after some point it will be very simple for you. Then you can draw the graph very easily and you can take the product and you can add and find the result very easily. I'm going to write the equation for y of 3. Y of 3 equal to sigma k equal to minus infinity to infinity. X of k is same into h of n minus k. Here n is 3, 3 minus k. Or you can write this 3 minus k as, I've told you that you can write it as minus k plus 3. Okay, here you have your minus k plus 2. How will you get minus k plus 3 from minus k plus 2? That is simply by adding 1 to the time positions. So first I'm going to draw this h of minus k plus 3 from my h of minus k plus 2. So I'm going to add a 1 to these time points. That is, I'm going to take h of minus k plus 3. The time positions will be, adding a 1 to 0 will give you a 1. 1 plus 1 will give you 2. 2 plus 1 will give you a 3. So you have your signal at positions 1, 2, and then 3. So this is your h of minus k plus 3. Now, in order to find y of 3, take the product of the common terms from x of k and h of minus k plus 3. The values are at 1, 2, and 3. So what is the value at 1 here for x of k? It is, so I'll write it here. So at 1, the value is 2 for x of k, and here the value is 1. So 2 into 1 plus. For the time position 2, the value is 3. So 3 into, here it is 1 plus. For the position 3, the value is 1. So 1 into 1. That is 2 plus 3 plus 1 equal to 6. So you got your result, that is y of 3 equal to 6. So similarly, you have to vary your h of k as h of minus k plus 4 and h of minus k plus 5 to get your y of 4 and y of 5. So while doing this, you will get your results, that is y of 4 as 4 and y of 5 as 1. So these are the points. So your y of n is set 1, 3, 6, 6, 4, 1 is your linear convolution result. So this is how you can perform linear convolution using graphical method. So this is actually a very simple method. I told you can also find the linear convolution using circular convolution, and that I have explained in my video, and I have also given the link in my description box. Okay, so this method is actually a little difficult for the beginning, but if you practice it, it is very easy. And if you are approaching or facing a question in exam, please don't skip such questions. If you find difficult in understanding this step or method, please do watch the video once again. It is very easy to understand and it is a very simple method. So this is how you have to find the linear convolution using graphical method. I really hope that you gained some knowledge from this video and you liked watching the video. And if yes, please do give it a thumbs up and also do subscribe to the channel and never forget to share this video with your friends. Thank you.